Hello guys, we are back with our next tutorial. In this tutorial, let us go through transmission media. So I hope everyone knows that what is a transmission media. Basically, what is transmission media, guys? The sender will send the data and receiver will receive the data, right? So in between, it travels through some places. So that is nothing but our transmission media. So we can say it is a physical connection or a wireless connection. Fine. Okay, so now let us go through the definition so that you'll be having a clear idea. In data communication terminology, a transmission media is a physical path between the sender and receiver. That is, it is the channel through which the data is sent from one place to another place. Fine? Okay. So basically the transmission media are divided into two types, guys. Guided media, unguided media. Guided means wired, unguided means wireless. Fine? So in guided media, we are having coaxial cable, fiber optics and twisted pair. Coaxial cable, we are having baseband and broadband. Twisted pair, we are having unshielded and shielded. Whereas in unguided media, we are having radio, micro and infrared. Fine? So these are all the different transmission mediums in which we can travel, which we can make the data travel between the sender and receiver. So now let us go through the first, what is guided media? And after that, we will be going through guided media. And after that, we will be going through unguided media also in this lecture only. So get ready. This lecture will be almost around 10 minutes. So please make your time and listen it, guys. Please be careful because this topic can be asked for 5 marks or even if you are lucky, it can also be asked for directly for 10 marks. So please understand the concept so that it will be really easy for you to understand it. Okay. So now let us start. Okay. So basically it is also referred as a wired or bounded transmission. So I told you, guided means we will be having the wired connections. Okay, so here are the futures. What are the futures, guys? We will be having high speed, high security. Guys, remember, guided media is high secured than unguided, guys. Okay, and used for comparatively shorter distances. So this is a small advantage, disadvantage in this. We'll be using for shorter distances only. So now let us go through the first type, that is nothing but twisted pair. So I told you twisted pair is again of two types, unshielded and shielded. So we'll be discussing about them also, don't worry. Okay, so twisted pair. So basically twisted. Means they are twisted among themselves. So this is nothing but twisted, right? So the one wire will be a conductor and another wire will be an insulator. So these two are insulated really tightly. Sorry. These two are paired or twisted really tightly. And in this way, we will be having multiple wires in a single wire, guys. So that is nothing but a twisted pair. Okay. So now let us go through them. So it consists of separate wires, those are nothing but insulator and conductor wires wounded about each other. Generally, several such pairs are bounded together. Okay, so that is nothing but a twisted pair. So, I hope everyone now got a small idea on twisted pair. So, now let us go through unshielded twisted pair. So, from the name itself, we can say it is not having any shield or anything like that. So, this type of cable has an ability to block interfaces and does not depend on physical shield. So, it is not going to have any physical shield, guys. But it has the ability to block the interfaces. So interface is nothing but some external media noises or any kind of things. It can stop by itself. So that is nothing but an unshielded. So used for telephonic applications. Fine. And here this is a small diagram for it, guys. So here do we have any shield, guys? So these are the two coaxial cables. So this is the insulated wire for those things. And these are the cables, guys. So the one cable will be an insulator and the other will be a conductor. Similarly here, like this, we will be having a number of wires twisted into some pair of wires. Fine? So in this way. So if you ever cut the LAN wire and if you have observed, there will be almost 10 to 12, I think 9 wires. So inside that, you will be having 9 wires, guys. So that is nothing but a twisted pair. In that, you will be having some twisted wires of insulator and conductor. So that will be the best example for this, guys. So here we are not having any shield. So the advantage will be it is cheap and installation will be really easy and we can use it for high speed LANs also. The disadvantage is it is really for the shortest distances, guys, because it's not having shield, right? So if we use for longer distances, there could be a chances of losing of data and many damages. Okay. So now let us go through shielded twisted pair. So just now we have discussed about unshielded, right? So here we will be discussing about shield. So there will be a particular shield for it. So this type of cable consists of a special jacket, that is nothing but shield, to block the external interfaces. So previously it used to block by itself. So here we will be using it external interface. So it is used as Ethernet and telephonic lines. Okay. So in this way it will be there, the shield will be there, and the advantages are easy to install and high quality will be there and fast transfer. So we can transfer the data at really faster And the only disadvantage here is it is more expensive, guys. When we compare with unshielded, this is a bit expensive. So I hope everyone got a small idea on this. So now let us go through coaxial cable. I told coaxial cable is also divided into two types, baseband and broadband. So the thing that you should remember is that coaxial cable is really important and it's easy, guys. The concept of coaxial cable is really easy. Okay, so just understand the thing. It has an outer plastic cover containing two parallel conductors, each have a separate insulator protection. So this will be our jacket, that is nothing but our protection. So we are having two modes in this, guys. One is broadband and the other is baseband. So basically these both allow the transmission of both telephonic signals and our internet in a single cable. Fine. Broadband is nothing but it is defined as a process of transmitting multiple signals simultaneously. So in broadband we can send them multiple signals simultaneously, and in baseband it is not possible, guys. Only single signal at moment of time. So it is defined as a process of transmitting signal at a time. So I hope everyone got a small idea on this coaxial cable. So here we'll be having a jacket. For that we'll be having shields, insulator and conductors. So it will be in this way. So we will be having multiple shields and multiple insulators and multiple conductors. Fine. So here also we can achieve the high speed, high bandwidth, and this is better than twisted pair. So, and this is a bit more expensive when compared to them. Fine. So now let us go through optical fiber cable. Sorry for that, guys. Okay. So optical fiber cable. So optical fiber, I hope everyone has a small idea about optical fiber. So this optical fiber will be having a core which is made up of glass. Whenever a light, so here the data is transferred in terms of light, guys. So what is the speed of light, guys? It is almost 3.9 × 10⁻¹⁰ meters per second or kilometers per second, I think so. Okay, so in that range of speed it will be traveling, guys. At the rate high speed it will be traveling. So it uses the concept of reflection of light through the core which is made up of glass or plastic. It uses the transmission of a larger volume. Okay, so here we will be having jack, cladding and core. So in core it will be reflecting and refracting again and again, and here we will be having the greater bandwidth, faster speed and long distances, but it is expensive. So I hope everyone got a small idea on this fiber cable. So basically if you take the high end plans in any kind of data providers, telecommunication providers, so like BSNL, the high end plan of almost 1000 or 1500, they will be providing you this optical fiber, guys. And even in you will be saying that ACT fiber and everything, right? So even at the basic plans of ACT fiber, they will be providing this optical fiber. So I hope everyone got a small idea on this. So now let us go through the unguided media. So here there will be no dedicated wire or anything like that. So it is also referred to wireless or unbounded transmission. So it can bound in all the directions and in any direction it wants. So the only disadvantage here is that it is less secured, but it is used for longer distances. And here we can broadcast through air, guys. There is no need of having wire connection. So we can move freely in our environment. Okay, so now let us first go through radio waves, guys. So I hope everyone knows about radio waves. Fine, so a particular frequency will be allotted for someone and they will be using it and they will be transmitting the data. And the other devices which are tuned for that particular frequency will be accepting that frequency. Fine, so these are easy to generate and can penetrate through buildings. Please remember, guys, this point is really important. Radio waves can penetrate through buildings. So the range will be 3 kilohertz to 1 gigahertz. So the best example will be FM radio. And the advantages is that covers a large area and penetrates through walls. Remember, this can be used for large area and penetrating through walls. And it provides a high transmission data rate speed. Okay. So now let us go through microwave. So microwave signals. So it is a line of sight transmitted that is from the sender to receiver antenna. So basically here we will be having the concept of antennas, guys. So at the top of the building you will be having an antenna. So this antenna will be sending the transmission data to the other antenna or to the satellite. So this is nothing but a microwave thing, guys. So microwave transmission. So here the antenna should be adjusted in an exact way such that they can transmit the data in an efficient manner. So that is the reason why in old movies they will be, or in the older TVs, they used to have an antenna at the top of the building and they used to adjust it whenever the network is not so good. They'll be trying to adjusting it by moving it in all the directions, and at some point of time they'll be achieving it. So that is nothing but the microwave transmission. So it is a line of sight transmission that is the sending and receiving antennas need to be aligned properly with each other. So here the speed will be, or the frequency will be 1 gigahertz to 300 gigahertz. Example will be TV antennas and satellites. So this cable is really cheaper and we can use it for larger area. So best example will be, sorry, disadvantage will be the bandwidth is limited. Fine. So now let us go through the infrared. So infrared, the best example for infrared is that we will be checking our navigation, right? So navigation and all those things will be using this infrared wave communication, guys. So infrared waves are used for very short distance communication and these cannot be penetrated through walls. Please remember that. So the example will be GPS and the range will be 300 gigahertz to 400 terahertz. So you can understand the range or bandwidth. So the advantage is we will be having high bandwidth, data rate speed will be really high. This is more secured and the disadvantage is that it cannot penetrate through walls or rocks. So I think any one of us didn't try that whether GPS is working below the rocks or not. So if possible, try it, guys. Just go to a cave and try it. GPS will not be working. So if you notice that whenever you are below a bridge or flyover, you notice that whenever you are navigate, you are using navigation, Google navigation or Google Maps, you'll be noticing that the icon that we are recognized in the system will not be moving. It will be stuck at that position. And once we cross the bridge only, then it recognizes that you moved forward. So I think everyone observed that. I observed that basically, guys. So that's the reason why I'm saying. So it cannot penetrate through walls or rocks. So that is the main reason. Okay. So I hope everyone is now clear with the transmissions mediums. So I hope everyone is clear with it. So in the next tutorial, we'll be going through the conversions between digital signals, guys. Thank you. Thanks for watching.